上周末在华盛顿由 Planned Parenthood 主办的 Bands of My Body 集会中，他们为了要用民族来煽动，就找了各个肤色、各个族裔的女性领袖上台发表讲话。这里面不光有白人，也不光有黑人，还有一个女生，姓 HSU， 是许还是徐，应该就是一个华人。那这些妇女代表呢，个个都义正言辞，好像自己就是那个促进时代变革的英雄。
Where are my Asian women at? An abortion plays a critical part in our reproductive lives. For our community, 35% of pregnancies end in abortion. But the path to get there is especially difficult and filled with deep cultural stigmas.But despite attempts to shame us, and we will not be shamed, AAPI women support, 85% of us support abortion access, and we demand our voices be heard today.
好丢人啊，我感觉他气得脸都扭在一起了。下面那个比手语的那个女生比她还生气。那除了她以外，还有人分享自己的堕胎经历，是堕胎成就了今天的她。
My abortion has given me the opportunity to continue school and receive my bachelor's degree. As of yesterday, I have now completed my master's degree as a social worker in direct practice in mental healthMy abortion opened up different avenues I hadn't previously considered and allowed me to have more empathy because I know I am not alone in my situation. I decided to become a volunteer because I was grateful of the care I received at Planned Parenthood. I believe we should normalize conversations around abortion and birth control in the Latinx community. And my abortion shouldAnd abortion should not just be legal, but accessible for everyone.
用堕胎换明天，他能够本科毕业，能够研究生毕业，都是因为他当时选择了堕胎吗？如果他当时生下来，把孩子送给别人领养，那他今天就会是一个 homeless 吗？这种逻辑完全不通顺的东西，就成为了他们给自己掩饰的一种方式。反正他念研究生，跟他付出的努力没有关系。跟他父母的培养也没有关系，倒是跟他自己出去乱跟别人睡觉，然后怀孕堕胎有关系。他并没有认为他杀死的是一个家庭成员，一个跟他最亲近的人，他也不认为他应该对这样一团细胞负上什么责任和代价，因为他自己犯了愚蠢的错误，创造出了一个生命，然后又犯了更愚蠢的错误，亲手杀死了自己的小孩。这样的什么支持堕胎的见证，我们在以前的节目中也有报道过，这种东西变成了他们堕胎教的生命分享见证，变成了扭转他们人生的高光时刻。见证的题目就是我如何通过杀死自己的小孩得到了撒旦的祝福，攀上了人生高峰。